हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू डेडमी। होप आप सभी का प्रिपरेशन अच्छे से चल रहे हैं। तो इस लास्ट फ्यू डेज में वी आर ट्राइंग टू हेल्प यू विद द रैपिड रिवीजन फ्रॉम ऑफ द करंट अफेयर्स, बिकॉज एज यू नो करंट अफेयर्स इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर द एग्जाम। तो इसलिए हम ला रहे हैं आप सभी के लिए लास्ट 1.5 ईयर्स का करंट अफेयर्स फ्रॉम ज्योग्राफी। तो दिस इज पार्ट 4 ऑफ द लेक्चर सीरीज। होप यू हैव सीन द अदर 3 पार्ट्स वेयर वी हैव कवर्ड वेरियस करंट अफेयर्स, एंड इन दिस पार्ट 4 we are going to cover current affairs, the remaining current affairs from flora, fauna and others. After that hum baat karte hain water bodies ke bare mein. After that we will talk about the natural resources current affairs, and finally the current affairs related to tribes and communities. To chaliye shuru karte hain. First, India's highest altitude all weather bridge. So recently it was inaugurated, it was in news, and this highest altitude all weather bridge was built over the Shyok river. It is located on the 255 kilometer Darbuk Shyok Daulabbai Goldi section. So it is located between Leh and Karakoram Pass. That is why this is important for us. India's high altitude all weather bridge. Next one, India's first underwater metro. So this was in news recently. So this underwater metro nears completion, and it is built in Kolkata. It is part of the iconic Hooghly River. Next, the legal rights to Ganga and Yamuna. So legal rights are being given to Ganga and Yamuna, and High Court has extended legal rights to Ganga and Yamuna. And who will be the parents for this Ganga and Yamuna? The Advocate General of the State of Uttarakhand and the Chief Secretary of the Uttarakhand State. The Chief Secretary and Advocate General, they will be declared as a loco parenti, that is the human face to protect these rivers. So when these rivers are given the legal rights, that means the glaciers including Gangotri, Yamunotri, rivers, streams, riverlets, lakes, air meadows, dales, jungles, forests, wetlands, grasslands, everything in the region, everything that are related to these rivers, they are given this human status. So they have all the legal rights that humans have. Next one, the Kajin Sara Lake. The Kajin Sara Lake is a newly discovered lake in Nepal, and this is the world's highest lake. So Kajin Sara Lake is the lake in Nepal. Next, Pangong So Lake was in use. The Pangong So Lake, recently it was in use because Indian troops and the Chinese troops clashed near to this lake. It is a 135 kilometer long lake, that means it is a very big lake, and it is located approximately 4,350 kilometers. It is a saltwater lake. It is formed from Tethys geosynclinus. So the geosynclinus is a linear trough. It is formed due to the folding of the region. So when the Himalayas are formed, the lake also formed near the Tethys Sea. That is why it is the Tethys geosynclinus. Next one, the Sukapaika. The Sukapaika, it is one of the distributaries of Mahanadi River in Odisha. The river recently died because of the lack of apathy from the government and other or the local people. It is mainly because the riverbed has suffered erosion, and also the river is full of the water hyacinth, which is an invasive crop. When the water hyacinth, these invasive crops are present, what will happen is that they will consume all the resources of that lake, of that river. And because of that, what will happen is the living organisms which are living there will not get enough nutrition, will not get food, and they will die. So subsequently what will happen is the river will die. That means the oxygen content in that river reduces and the toxicity increases. That is about the Sukapaika. Sukapaika is a tributary of Mahanadi River in Odisha. Next, Mahadai River was in use. Mahadai River is a west flowing river. It is located in between Karnataka and Goa. So there's a dispute between the Karnataka and Goa because of this river. The river originates in Karnataka and it flows from Karnataka to Goa. So it travels 35 kilometers in Karnataka and 82 kilometers in Goa before joining the Arabian Sea. It's a west flowing river. And Goa has raised objection to Kalsa Banduri project of Karnataka. Kalsa Banduri project is the project over Mahadai River. The Mahadai River is known as Mandovi River in Goa. Mandovi River in Goa, and Goa has moved to the Supreme Court, and there is a tribunal with regarding to this dispute. So Mahadai River and Mandovi River. Next, the Sukna Lake. Sukna Lake was given a living entity status. by the Punjab and Haryana High Court, and all the people of Chandigarh, they are the loca parentis. That means they all the people are combinedly are the parents of this lake. They will be responsible to save the lake from extinction. Next, polymetallic nodules was in use. So the polymetallic nodules, what are these? So these are the nodules, or you can say these are the mineral deposits which are located in the ocean. Mineral deposits in the ocean, and India is mining these. India have actually rights for mining these polymetallic nodules in the Indian Ocean region. Okay, and so the polymetallic nodules, they are potato shaped nodules where they compose of lot of minerals. So mining these, you know, will give us lot of minerals, and this is a very economical and strategic importance. So the world's second largest coal block was discovered. It is the Dichu Panchami coal block of Birbhum coal field area in West Bengal. So Dichu Panchami coal block in West Bengal, it is the world's second largest coal block. It is the largest coal mine or coal block in Asia. Largest coal mine in Asia, which is Dichu Panchami coal block, and this is the second largest in the world. Next, Vadhavan port. Recently it was in news because the Vadhavan port, it will be set up as the 13th major port in Maharashtra, near Dhano in Maharashtra, with a cost of about 65,545 crores. This will be the 13th major port. So till now we have 12 major ports. They are, the first is the Deen Dayal port, erstwhile the Kandla port in Gujarat. Next, the Mumbai port, the JNPT port, this is also near to Mumbai. Next, the Marmagova port, the new Mangalore port, the Cochin port, the Chennai port, the earlier Ennore port, which is now known as Kamarajar port, the Chidambaran port, the Vishakhapatnam port, Paradip port, and the Kolkata port. So these are the 12 major ports. So the Vadhavan port will be 13th major port. Remember these 12 major ports. Next one, the particularly vulnerable tribes were in the news. What were the particular vulnerable tribal groups? These are the most vulnerable tribal groups. So these are the most vulnerable ones. So their population has been declining because of the latest technologies and various other reasons, ecological, both environmental and the changing, you know, global scenario. Because of these reasons, their population has been decreasing. They generally inhabit remote localities. That means they are very far off from the mainstream society. Okay, they have poor infrastructure and administrative support, the particularly vulnerable tribal groups. And in 1975, Government of India initiated a program to identify these particularly vulnerable tribal groups. And we have a separate category called PVT category, and it declared 52 such groups. Okay, so additional 23 groups were added later. So total we have 75 particular vulnerable tribal groups. So how many we have? 75. And the important thing to note here is that the important thing is highest number of particularly vulnerable tribal groups are found in Odisha, followed by Andhra Pradesh. So first is Odisha, second is Andhra Pradesh. So these are spread over 18 states and Andaman Nicobar Islands. Okay, so this Odisha has the largest or highest number of particularly vulnerable tribal groups, followed by Andhra Pradesh. Next one, the Kodavas community of Coorg was in use. It is because the central government has decided to continue the British era rule of exempting the Kodava community from obtaining a license for firearms. So the Kodava community can have firearms. So why this was given? Because it is a tradition. Traditionally, they worship weapons. Okay, the Kodava community, they are part of the Karnataka region. So they are located in Karnataka region, and they worship the weapons during the Kailopod festival. So Kailpod festival is celebrated in that region. So central government has decided to continue with the old rule of exempting this community from the permission, or you can say from obtaining the license for the weapons. Next one, Bodos were in use. Bodos are the single largest tribal community in Assam. Bodos are situated in Assam. They make up to 5 to 6% of the state's population. Bodos in Assam. So there are four districts: the Korkajar, Baksa, Udalgiri, and Chirang. So these constitute the Bodo territorial area district, and they are home to various ethnic groups also. Okay, Bodos are in Assam. This is important for us. Now let's just revise what we have covered till now. First, the highest altitude all-weather bridge in India. It is built on the Shok River. So the river is known as, so the bridge is known as the Colonel Chewang Rinchetu Setu, Chewang Rinchen Setu. It is built on the Shok River. okay, so this is part of the Darbuk Shok Daulatbek Goldi section. Okay, it is located in the eastern Ladakh region, so that is why this is important. It is over the Shok River. This is important for us. And the first underwater metro, it is, you know, near completion, Kolkata. First underwater metro in Kolkata. Next, legal rights are given to Ganga and Yamuna. Ganga Yamuna and the Uttarakhand Advocate General and Uttarakhand State Chief Secretary are responsible for the you can say they are the parents for protecting these rivers, Ganga and Yamuna. Next, Kajin Sara Lake. So Kajin Sara Lake recently was discovered in Nepal, and this will be the world's highest lake, Kajin Sara Lake in Nepal. Pangong So Lake was in news. Pangong So Lake is located in Ladakh. Okay, this is 135 kilometer long lake between India and China. India and China. Next, Sukha Paika. Sukha Paika is the distributary of, you can see it is a distributary of Mahadai River in Odisha. Recently it died because of the water hyacinth. Sukha Paika is in the Mahanandi River. Next, Mahadai River. Mahadai River originates in Karnataka. So there's a dispute between Mahadai River and the Mahadai River between Karnataka and Goa. The Mahadai River is also known as the Mandovi River in Goa. The Mahadai River is a west flowing river. Okay, it flows 35 kilometers in Karnataka and 82 kilometers in Goa before joining the Arabian Sea. And Goa raised objection with regarding to the Kalsa Banduri project of Karnataka. Kalsa Banduri project of Karnataka. Next, Sukna Lake in Chandigarh was given a living status, and all the people are the parents for this for the Sukna Lake, and they are responsible for saving the Sukna Lake. Okay, next one, the polymetallic nodules. The polymetallic nodules are the nodules, they are the mineral deposits in the ocean. Mineral deposits in the ocean. So they have various minerals like iron, manganese, nickel, copper, cobalt, lead, molybdenum, cadmium, vanadium, titanium. So various various minerals are found in this polymetallic nodules, and India have a right to extract, or you can say to mine, these minerals in the Indian Ocean region. The world's second largest coal block is the Dichu Panchami coal block of Birbhum coalfield area in West Bengal. So Dichu Panchami coal block in West Bengal, it is the largest coal mine or coal block in Asia. That is the Dichu Panchami coal block. Next, Vadhvan port. This will be set up as the 13th largest port. The Vadhvan port will be the 13th major port of India. Currently we have 12 major ports. Vadhvan port in Maharashtra will be the 13th major port. Next, particularly vulnerable tribal groups are the most vulnerable tribal groups in the country. And highest number of particularly vulnerable tribal groups are located in Odisha, followed by Andhra Pradesh. Next, Kodava communities are part of Coorg. They are situated in Coorg in Karnataka. Okay. And recently central government has exempted they have given permission for this community to have license for the firearms, because they in the festival of Kalipod festival, so they will worship these weapons. Next, Bodos are in news. Bodos are a tribal community of Assam. Okay, so that's it friends in this lecture. Next lecture, the part 5, you know, I'll see you with that lecture. Till then, keep studying and stay tuned. Jai Hind.